This protest was the beginning of the end for Sumay Lumaiga. These images show opposition supporters and Muslim religious leaders taking to the streets together to demand he step down. On Wednesday, legislators submitted a motion of no confidence against the government, blaming the administration for failing to clamp down on violence gripping the center of the country. Last month, in the village of Ogasugu, 160 Fulani herders, including women and children, were killed by what appeared to be members of a rival community. It was bloody, even by recent standards of Mali's ever-worsening violence. The brutal massacre shocked the nation, prompting protests as the government failed to disarm the militia many believed responsible. President Keita announced Thursday that he'd accepted the prime minister's and the entire cabinet's resignation, and said he'd name a successor soon.